Special cleaning may be required as well for heavy equipment, such as J5 dozers, construction and road building equipment, logging equipment, or augers. Most road construction and maintenance equipment has a lower risk of spreading invasive species because they are not used in natural areas. However, those that move soil might be carrying invasive plant seeds with that soil. This gives equipment such as road graders the potential to deposit invasive plant seeds along the road's edge. From there, invading plants spread to the adjacent land. The wheels, blade, and hydraulic lifting bars of a road grader should get the most attention for cleaning. For hand cleaning, a pry bar, hammer, and chisel are good additions to the regular cleaning tools for removing compacted soil. Be cautious around the hot engine and avoid getting grease on your brush because it may catch seeds that you could redeposit elsewhere on the equipment. A leaf blower with a nozzle to direct the air or an air compressor with an extension wand will help cleaning off loose, dry soil. For wet soil, wash it off with water. Be sure to check the manufacturer's operating instructions and safety warnings before using a power washer. A mobile washing company can also be hired to do this work on site. There are not a lot of places on a road grader to carry cleaning tools, so you may want to add a storage box or brackets to carry the most useful tools to the work sites.
Because of the nature of the work done by tracked equipment, such as bulldozers, it poses a number of challenges for cleaning off dirt and plant debris. Soil and plants are often tightly compacted on the blade, undercarriage, and tracks. Water and hand tools will do the best job of removing this compressed dirt. Air pressure can help with loose plant debris and soil, and may dislodge dry, compacted dirt that has been loosened by hand. It may be hard to carry the cleaning equipment on the bulldozer itself, so plan other ways to get the needed equipment to each work site. The tracks, holes, and rollers in the undercarriage can take considerable time to clean, and you'll need to move them several times to get all parts cleaned. You may need to plan for more than an hour of cleaning time in your workday. You will also need to make contractors aware of the cleaning requirements and the time needed. If the bulldozer is working in areas where there is a high risk of spreading invasive species, plan to have cleaning water available on the site in order to completely clean it. If you're unable to do a thorough cleaning of a bulldozer at the site, remove as much soil and vegetation as possible, and then transport the dozer directly to a location where the cleaning can be completed. Some of the risk of spreading invasive species in vegetation may be reduced by doing bulldozer work in the winter. However, seeds in the soil are a concern. Cleaning dirt off will be more difficult in the winter because of the snow and ice mixed in, and it may be very difficult to do the cleaning on site. Vehicles used by office staff can carry terrestrial invasive species too, if they have been used for surveys, tours, and site visits. If the vehicles have mud or plants on them, they should be cleaned before leaving sites. This also applies to the cars and pickups used by contractors to move between natural sites. Does your office loan out small equipment, hand tools, or bigger equipment such as weed wrenches, planters, or seeders to private citizens for natural resource work? These can be another route for transporting terrestrial invasive species. Teach the borrower how to properly clean the equipment to prevent the spread of invaders. Make sure this equipment is clean when it is loaned out and cleaned at the site where it is used before being returned to the DNR.
As I'm working to control the spread of invasive species, I don't want to take them to new sites on my boots.
When you're cleaning up before leaving a site, don't forget to remove mud and plant material from your personal equipment, clothing, and footwear as well. This includes scraping, brushing, and washing off hand tools and power tools, including saws, weed cutters, shovels, picks, rakes, axes, pressure washers, seed harvesting tools, and survey gear. Portable equipment may have also picked up invasive species, so be sure to clean off monitoring equipment, scoops, containers, erosion barriers, portable pumps, fire apparatus, prescribed burn tools, and generators. And you'll even need to clean off your cleaning tools and equipment. Don't forget to clean your personal clothing. As you know, creatures, seeds, and plant material can cling to your clothing. If you carry invasive species into a car or truck, they could be left on the seat or floor to become attached to the next person in the vehicle and transported to a new site. Stop these hitchhikers by carefully cleaning your boots, waders, helmet, fire gear, shirt, pants, rain gear, hat, and gloves. You can also bag some equipment for later cleaning. Especially check hidden areas such as pant cuffs and the folds and pockets of backpacks. Some seeds, such as burdock and cocklebur, have hairs and hooks that can cling easily to fabric surfaces, so inspect your clothing for them. Of course, contractors need to clean their personal equipment as well before leaving the worksite.
I work for the DNR because I care about Minnesota's resources. I don't want to be the person responsible for introducing a new invasive species to a site. You don't want to be that person either. Remember to arrive at your work sites with clean equipment, clothing, and vehicles. And when you leave, have them in that same condition.
As you've learned, different kinds of equipment, tools, and vehicles may require specialized approaches to cleaning. But no matter what you're cleaning, you have the same goals. Remove seeds, plant debris, and animals to prevent the spread of terrestrial invasive species from one site to another. Remove soil and mud that might harbor seeds, reproductive plant material, and animal parts that could start a new infestation. And above all, don't give terrestrial invasive species hitchhikers a ride with you from one site to another as you do your work. Stopping the spread of invasive species helps protect the resources we manage for all Minnesotans. Remember, work, clean, go. Stop invasive species in your tracks.